because I was in corporate banking, it always made me stop and try and see things much more from the customer perspective. I think until that moment, all the training that I'd had as a banker was about what the bank wants, how the bank should interpret this, and where we should do it. And what common purpose does is it always makes you think and say, hang on, what's the perspective from the other side of the table here? And I spent a lot more time thinking about what's the customer trying to get out of this? Where are they really going? How do I get under their skin and really appreciate where this can go? And quite often we ended up with not the deal that the customer wanted, but something that was much more creative and positive for both parties and actually really locked us into a much tighter relationship. And it helped me hugely because subsequent to that, and I did common purpose up in the Northeast, I then moved down to the West Midlands, which was quite a different banking environment, but I got heavily engaged with Common Purpose down there as well. And as a result of it, started to see some of the bigger picture stuff that Barclays was up to at the time, and therefore ended up becoming marketing director. Not because I was good at the pretty picture side of marketing, but because I was really trying to challenge some of the market analysis and some of the thinking that was going on. And I think some of the ability to look at the bigger picture and understand all the other pressures on the organisation, and much of which was thanks to Common Purpose's approach, enabled me to do that too. I think that anyone who's been through Common Purpose comes out of their sort of tunnel vision. That people who have worked for, you know, many years, and in fact many tens of years in some cases, in one particular profession, industry, business, whatever, sees the world through, you know, one particular viewpoint. What Common Purpose does is completely opens your eyes to the fact that all these other sectors that you've probably sat and slightly insulted over the years are actually all doing an incredibly valuable job, are all very, very dedicated, and all have a different point of view, but still a very valid point of view. And when you understand the problems that they face and the reason that they have to see it from that perspective because of the nature it fits, it allows you to work with them and understand how to actually reach mutual agreements with them in a way that you can't if you've only ever worked in your own sector. And so in a very short space of time, and normally with the main program, you know, less than a year, you actually pick up a massive amount of knowledge that allows you to work cross-sectorally. And if I take my own case in point, you know, I was working in banking when I first did Common Purpose. I've changed profession quite a lot since then, but not only that, I've ended up with a wide range of extracurricular roles at pretty senior levels in the public sector, the private sector, and the voluntary sector, none of which I think I'd have had either the courage or indeed the understanding to be able to contribute to if I hadn't been through that Common Purpose experience. Common Purpose has been absolutely central to helping people from all sectors talk together and work together. I think most days were an aha moment of some sort. I think that for me personally, the public sector and the crime and justice and the education days were the ones that probably had them, because they were the ones most outside my sphere of knowledge. I think we all think that we understand education, but actually when we look at it, we realise we've probably only been through one very narrow bit of it, and it opened my eyes as to the huge range and actually completely changed my perceptions between the public and the private education systems, and really made me think very, very hard about the way that those two both work and don't work. And I think that actually just getting under the skin of how local authorities go about their daily work was often the other one, because it's amazing how few people ever get inside the way that local authorities think. We probably sit at home and rant about them, but we never really try and get under the skin of the way that they think.